जय गुरु जी, शुक्राना गुरु जी, अनंतम अनंतम कोटि कोटि शुक्राना मेरे गुरु जी। लाइट ऑफ डिविनिटी, लाइक द सन राइजिंग सडनली ऑन अ सोडन लैंडस्केप, इट इज नॉट विद इन माई कैपेसिटी और कंपिटेंस टू पुट इन टू वर्ड्स द सुपरमेसी ऑफ माई गुरु, फॉर हाउ कैन आई डू जस्टिस इन कोल्ड वर्ड्स टू हिज कोलोसल डिविनिटी। हाउएवर, इन द सिंसियर ट्रिब्यूट ऑफ लव एंड रेवरेंस For my guru, I share my experience of supreme blessings with his approval. The path we seek is not different from the summit of salvation, the purpose of our being. The journey from seeking to reaching this summit is akin for those who entrust their reins in the hands of their guru. For we are not pathfinders but followers. I was born into a Jat Sikh family. My family had to its credit happiness, tasteful living, good education and discipline. Throughout my childhood, I have always been influenced by my grandfather, a devout follower of his faith and of his master. Slowly, the import of finding a guru dawned on me. I was married into a Jat Sikh family. My husband, the only son after three daughters in his family, was brought up with a lot of affection, which he seemed to have taken for granted. He learned to have his way to his negligence towards the family and lack of responsibility towards himself can perhaps be attributed his fondness for alcohol, his major problem. It is a dream of every girl to be happily married, and I was no exception. But when a family is haunted with alcoholism, nothing is any longer in anyone's control, and worldly fetters and problems become insurmountable. The burden of responsibility and my unhappiness soon disillusioned me. During that time, my grandfather visited me. My inner turmoil reached out to him without words, and he assumed I needed some help. My eyes filled up with tears, and I told him that I wanted him to pray for me to find a Puran Guru, a complete and perfect master. However, harder mortal being may try, she cannot find an enlightened master. The master finds her when she is ready to tread his path. Shortly, my mother took me to visit Guruji in Chandigarh. From the moment I stepped into Guruji's, I could smell roses, and the sight of him flooded my eyes with tears. For the next few hours that I sat there, tears kept streaming down my eyes. Many times after first meeting Guruji, I could not control the outburst of emotions, and I simply could not understand why. Every time I visited him, I experienced a peace that passed understanding. It was as if the flood of tears was singularly transforming me by some alchemical cleansing. In the meantime, my husband began to drink more. He lost all sense of responsibility and was squandering money. I tried telling him about Guruji and also persuaded him to meet Guruji. He laughed at me, saying such gurus were a dime a dozen, and teased me about my conservative attitude. He also did not approve of my visiting Guruji. Around November 1999, my husband was posted to Lebanon on a UN mission. There his drinking problem worsened, and he was diagnosed as having liver cirrhosis. Our world fell apart. I took the first flight to be with him. The doctor clearly stated that his liver had packed up and that he would require a transplant within 2 years. To find a donor in such a short period was a near impossibility. Even if a donor was found, a transplant would have been exorbitant and in many cases unsuccessful. Doctors cautioned my husband that even a single drop of alcohol taken henceforth would prove fatal. Meanwhile, my parents kept going to Guruji and praying for my husband's life. After being in the hospital for a few weeks, we came back to Delhi. I requested him to meet Guruji. He did come, but all the while that he was there, he sat in a corner and complained of how tired he was and how I had forced him to come. The same night I approached Guruji and was so full of emotion that I could hardly speak. My mother and I prayed in front of him to save my husband, and Guruji replied, "How can I help him? He is a non-believer." In the days that followed, I would visit Guruji alone because my husband would never accompany me. One night after returning from Guruji's place, while I was fast asleep, a sudden great force like a whooshing wind entered my room. I was so scared that I sat upright in my bed and started saying my prayers with my eyes closed. I experienced white light piercing the darkness and flooding the center of my forehead. Guruji was within that white light. He said he would cure my husband now. In the 15 to 20 minutes that followed, I smelled nauseating odors similar to those that emanate from operating rooms. After a while, everything cleared up and I went back to sleep. Guruji told me he had blessed my husband. 6 years have passed since that day and my husband continues to drink relentlessly, keeping in mind what the doctors had said. My family and I are amazed at how Guruji is looking after him day and night. My husband, in his own way, believes and recognizes the gift of life given to him by Guruji. The time-tested scriptures of the word all agree that before man born, the day of his death is as certain, and that no one can grant him even a breath more. However, the power to burn man's karma lies with the Supreme Creator. Guruji is that cosmic director, the manifestation of that supreme power, who rewrote the play of my life. My family and I have experienced numerous incidents where we have called out to Guruji and have suddenly seen things fall into place as if touched by a magic wand. I once had the privilege of escorting more than half a dozen friends to whom I had been singing the praises of my guru to meet Guruji. With my limited vision, I prevailed upon them to not asking for anything, though it was contrary to what I had done. When I touched the feet of my guru, he looked at me and, to my astonishment, said that everyone came to him to ask for something. Like a divine mirror, Guruji apparently had caught the reflection of my mind, and each of my friends was blessed and their desires fulfilled. No one who comes near him ever goes back empty-handed. Upon touching his feet, a businessman might be blessed with prosperity, a sick man with health, and a student with knowledge. Some are aware of the gift they receive, others ignorant of the hidden blessings. His love knows no bounds and immaterial of whether you are a believer or a non-believer. His grace touches everyone. He makes no demands. Asks you to keep no promises, but slowly his divine presence weaves magic and transforms you from within. Every day, people ridden with sorrow come in his presence, and his grace illuminates their faces like the sudden rising of the sun over a social landscape. Satsang shared by one of the devotees. Satsang of a devotee. Jai Guruji, Shukrana Guruji, Anantam Anantam, Koti Kotin Shukrana Mere Gurupa, Om Namah Shivaya Shivaji Sada Sahai, Om Namah Shivaya Guruji Sada Sahai, Jai Guruji, Shukrana Guruji, Jai Guruji Sangaji, Jai Guruji.